Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catch and Cloud, the leader in e-commerce accounting. Today, I want to show you how to use Xero without bank feeds. I've already done a video about how to use Xero with bank feeds, but you know, sometimes you've got a bank that's from like the 1980s and it doesn't talk to any of the other tools out there. So usually it's in like small towns, local banks and things like that. But there is a workaround for actually working with the bank, even if there's no direct connection set up. So I'm going to show you how to do that. You're going to log into your bank. You're going to go try and see if you can download the data because it's just faster and easier. If you go to download, you'll get different types of files. Xero takes OFX, QFX, QBO, QIF, and CSV. In my experience, if you can grab one of these Quicken or QuickBooks files, it actually is going to go a lot faster. You won't have to do quite as much data manipulation. In fact, I don't think you can do data manipulation. You download it, you import it, and it works. But I want to show you how to use the CSV file because even if you download, and here, let me just pop over here and do it. So when you download this file, it's going to give you dates and descriptions and amounts. You'll notice that all the expenses are negative numbers and there aren't any positive numbers here. If there was like a payment or something like that, it would show up as a positive number. So you just need to be aware of that. The good thing about CSV files is you don't even need to download it from anywhere. You could just like pull open your Excel program or Google Sheets, type in some information that you need into your system really quickly, and then download it as a CSV and pop it into Xero. So that's exactly what we're gonna do here. You'll notice that all these dates, the years have four digits that is easier for the system to understand. But we're just gonna take this raw thing that they sent over and we're going to import it. So you can get here from either the dashboard, or you go to manually import statement, or you can find a dropdown to import a statement. It all gets you to the same place, which is this screen that says import bank transactions. You can download a CSV template if you want to, but you don't need to because you're going to map where all the different fields are going to go. So it doesn't really matter what order it's in. And we're just going to go find that file. Okay, so I found the file and I'm going to import it, and it'll take you to a screen that's really pretty straightforward. If you need help, you can look at their little getting started guide, but here's basically what you care about. You want to record your transaction based on the transaction date, the description. You might want as description, or you might want it as payee. It kind of depends how the information downloaded. Actually, I'll just put as description. The only two fields that you really definitely need are the amount and the date. Everything else is kind of superfluous. It helps, but it's not necessary. And actually, if you have an account code and you've got a tax type, it does something super cool, which you can see in this tips video right here. Okay, so after you've looked at this, you can look down here and see a preview here. If the transaction is showing up as a debit and it's an expense, then you know you've got stuff going the right way. If, however, this is showing up as a credit and shows up over here, you want to cancel this, change the signs on your CSV file, and try doing it again. Okay, so in this case, we're just going to import this. Actually, and you can scroll through and you can see how everything's going to come through, just so you can make sure that you like how it looks. So when you hit save, it's going to give you a little window that says, hey, we imported everything and nothing was a duplicate. Yay. And you say, okay. And then once that happens, you'll have exactly the view that you would have if it was directly connecting to the bank and pulling in a bank feed from there. Okay, so that's really quick and easy. Let me show you one bonus tip which will help you. If you happen to have a CSV file, so let's pretend, actually I'm going to show you how to undo this too. Let's go to bank statements and go to statements. If you click on that, it gives you a list of all the transactions. Let's say you accidentally imported this twice. We're just going to delete the entire statement. And it's gone, and you can just start over. So it's nice and clean and easy like that. But let's say when we went to import it, all the digits, like all the signs were going the wrong way. Okay. I'm going to show you how to fix that. Okay, so I went in this file, I changed all the signs so they're positive instead of negative. So we're importing this file again with the signs changed. When we import it, you'll notice, first of all, it's going to entirely skip that screen with the mapping on it because Xero already knows. It says, hey, I've seen this file before. I know how to map stuff already because you already told me. So if you're always importing things in the same format, then you can skip that step. Second thing I want to point out is that all of the transactions are now showing up as received money instead of as spent money as it had been before, which makes sense because we changed the signs, so that's what you would expect. But let me show you one other thing. So what happens if you import the statement and then you realize after you've imported it, oh, I meant for the transaction or for the description field to be the payee or something got mapped wrong. Well, if it skips that mapping field, then you're kind of like, what do I do? That's not good. Okay. So I'm actually going to go in here and delete what we did just so that I can start over again and delete that entire statement. All right. So let me show you what you need to do. Okay, so here's your file. Actually, I'm going to change these back to what it was before, just because I'm an accountant and so stuff like that bugs me. This is fake data. I'm not even using it in the file, but you know. All right. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to trick the system. And what we're going to do is we're going to switch the columns around so that it thinks that it's a whole new file. And I would recommend changing this first column for sure. I'm not exactly positive how it figures it out. I just know like if I just move some stuff around, it kind of blows its mind and thinks about it. So, okay. Okay, I'm going to actually add in a new column here with a new heading just to make it even more confused. And there you go. So shift the columns around, add in a new column, maybe change the name of the headings, like just do what you can to just confuse Xero. But if you just shift it a little bit, then it will redo the mapping and you can fix it. And see, it's back to a debit thing right there. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please like, comment, share. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and I'll catch you later.